I'm making this video to show what I carry with me on these multi-month trips. To begin with, there's the suitcase you see. This thing. The suitcase is 52 centimeters by 28 by about 20. And everything I carry for 3 months is either on my back that I wear or in that suitcase. Or in this thing, which is the over-the-shoulder bag, which is, as you can see, somewhat smaller than the suitcase, but you're allowed to put a lot of stuff in there, and it's got a lot of pockets. Now, inside the suitcase, I put this thing. It's a it's a folder. Zippers on both sides and one on the top, and it comes in very handy. Over here, in the back of the suitcase, I put the pills that I carry. Around my neck is this carry around the shoulder thing where you got your passport and so on, and credit cards and money. What's amusing is this thing I carry with me, the red. It goes all the way from there across the room, here, all the way across the room. The value is that when you have a room like mine where it only has one outlet and you're in the bed on the other side, it extends everything. And when it reaches here to the other side, I have another one of these multi-prong extender things into which I can plug things, such as here is the transformer for the DVD player that I carry. This is a charger for one of my cell phones. Two more chargers for cell phones and other electronic things. And this blue thing, this is a adapter that changes 220 volts to 110 volts. And why is that important? Because I carry with me, at popular request, an electric vibrator. And the vibrator runs on 110 volts. But when you're here in 220 volt countries, you need the adapter. Here is the cell phone I use with, I have my music on. It's an old Nokia, but it's far superior to any of the modern ones. And this thing is, and I breathe in, I've got diagnosed with a mild asthma. All right, that covers this. Oh, yes, this is another extender with still more adapters. And well, this is the charger for the electric shaver, and these are two more adapters. All this I carry with me. Keep that in mind. Okay, more. This is an electric toothbrush, a spoon, sunglasses. This is an electric heater to boil water. You stick it into the water, it's 220 volts, and it boils it. And a comb, and this is a brush where you clean out the oatmeal that you make in the cup. I do not carry cups with me. They can be bought very cheaply, but the cleaner I carry with me. These are, as you can see, different plug adapters. This is a measuring, I forget the exact word, but you know, when you want to measure something, it takes up no space and I carry it. This is difficult to explain. You plug one end into the car and out come these wires, these cables, two of them, because it's a dual-prong thing. And into one you can plug the music player and the other the cell phone that it plays over the car speakers. And this is an electric plug-in if there are mosquitoes. There are no mosquitoes here in Bolivia. We're at 12,000 feet. This is an extra pair of sunglasses and an extra pair of reading glasses. This is GPS, which you can plug into the car. I carry it with me, so when I have a rental car, I plug it in, and it shows me it's a GPS. All right, this is a tablet, a fold. It's a Samsung tablet, but I bought as an accessory a keyboard. It gets stuck into the keyboard, and then you can just close it up, and you put it in the carrying case, and you've got a keyboard. Then I bring about 10 pair of socks. You can see that. And of course, I have to have a lot of name cards, visit cards with all the contact information. And this is a funny one. This is a stamp I bought where they can change and put in the stamp. On a stamp, I add to the local number that I'm using in whatever country I'm in. And this is headache pills, just in case, on the plane. This is an auxiliary power supply that you plug in to the cell phone when your power runs down. This is a mouse. These are my house keys and other important keys. This is a second cell phone. The first cell phone is what I'm using to make this story. And this is another auxiliary power, but since it's obviously larger than that, it carries much more capacity. And this is a lip balm, a little notepad, two pens, nail clipper. I got cut, so before leaving, a minor cut. That's over here. So you have the nonstick pad, antibiotic, and paper, what's called paper tape, that doesn't, and electric shaver, and the cleaner for the electric shaver, an extra wristwatch, which is identical to my favorite kind of watch, which is, you can see what I'm wearing, and here's another one, just in case the first one breaks. This is what I put the soap in, a soap dish, a thermometer. This thing, if I forget the name of it, but you rub it, if your bottom of your foot gets dry and peeling, you rub this on it and it takes it off. This is extra Band-Aids. I'm exhausted already from this description. I use eye drops when my eye is dry, dry eye. And this is a bunch of those, and pimple medicine and so on. And this is for when I'm in a 110-volt country like Ecuador. This is another thing to boil the water in a cup very quickly. This is a little device which tightens the screws on your sunglasses when they get loose. This is a miniature stapler with extra staples, as you can see, stapler and staples. This is an around-the-neck thing. You put it around your neck when you're swimming, and you can put important things like keys in it or money. So you have it with you. And this is a nose hair clipper, battery-operated. And this is a magnifying glass. This is quite amusing. A magnifying glass. And this is a really good compass that I bought in Canada. And this is extra blades for the shaver, because if the first one breaks, you'd never find the replacement. So I brought an extra with me. These are extra long rubber bands. Always useful. This is a magic marker. And these are little sticker things with stars where you can label things. And this is obviously a scotch tape. And this is extra scotch tape here. This is a DVD player. It's rather small. Here's my hand, so you can see the whole DVD player is not that big, but it's portable. And it's battery, and then you have a charger, and it's kept for safekeeping in this case, and I bring a full set of headphones because I plug the headphone into the DVD player and you get perfect sound. Now, on the plane, what do I wear? A pair of pants. I wear no shorts. I carry one pair of pants with me for several months. But I do clean them, don't worry. And a shirt, like the shirt I'm now wearing. So you got pants, you got shirts, you got jacket and lighter jacket, and over that you put the heavier leather jacket. So all this is worn when you go on the plane. And for shirts, I have 3 extra shirts. And for shorts, I bring 3 pair of shorts with me. I don't think I'm leaving anything out. That's the story. Everything that you've seen here somehow all gets packed into that valise, suitcase, which is small enough so that you can roll it on with you onto the cabin so you don't have to book anything, so there's no danger of losing, or if you don't lose it, doesn't make the change of flights, it arrives a day later. We've always had this experience. Plus the over-the-shoulder thing, which has got a bunch of pockets where a ton of stuff gets crammed in, and that's my little story. I'm going to put this up on the YouTube and then I'll send you the link. Oh, I left something out. My sandals. Of course, I bring sandals as well. So one single pair of shoes. I do wear shoes. I'm now looking for them. One pair of running shoes. It's under here. It's a little dark. Let me bring them out to the light. So the shoes that I wear, if you're wondering where are the guy's shoes, one pair of shoes and one pair of sandals. That's it. I think we have covered everything. Any questions, you can send them to me. You have my email address.